All right, guys, crazy times in the world right now. I hope everybody is staying safe and staying healthy. I have had endless touring cancellations, of course. I was supposed to be touring through 4 different continents and a bunch of different countries this spring, as well as around the U.S. Definitely a bummer to not be on the road, but everything's just postponed. You know, hopefully we'll be rescheduling a lot of stuff soon. And it's nice to be home a little bit more and have some time to make some more content for you guys, because it's always hard to squeeze this in between my busy touring schedule. So it's nice to be home a little bit more, and I'll be able to bring more content to you guys. So that in mind, we're going to check out some shredding phrases from this PDF using diminished scales and a variety of different chord progressions that you can use those scales on. And if you have anything in particular that you've been hoping that I could cover in these videos, make sure to leave that in the comments section today, and I'll get to that as soon as I can. So today we're going to go over a few really hip diminished phrases. In a recent video, we went over some diminished exercises that you could do for just kind of general scale technique and a whole bunch of variations that you can use, and adding some chromaticism in there as well and all that good stuff. Today, we are going to get into actual phrases. Sometimes that can be really great for actually integrating this type of sound into your playing and really mastering the diminished sound. So all of the phrases that we're gonna check out today are available as part of a PDF. That's going to be an instant download that you can get on jazzlessonvideos.com. It's called 65 Shredding Diminished Phrases, and that's going to be a really great PDF to check out with all these phrases written out in all 12 keys. So let's jump right into it. The first phrase is going to be a great phrase to use on a dominant chord, and we're going to be using the half whole diminished scale. So there are 3 different types of diminished scales. There's the half whole diminished scale, the whole half diminished scale, and the diminished whole tone scale, which is also referred to as the altered scale. And the PDF is gonna have phrases using all 3 of these scales. This first one is going to be with the half whole diminished scale. And the half whole diminished scale is going to be what you use on any type of dominant chord. If you wanna just kind of get some alterations going in that sound, you're gonna end up getting the flat 9, the sharp 9, and the sharp 11 in there. Or you could use it on a flat 9 dominant chord, and that's gonna get kind of just more of a darker sound. A lot of times you'll use this in context in things like minor 2 5s, and the PDF goes into a bunch of different progressions where you can use different diminished scales. But right now we're just going to go over some diminished licks that are gonna really work well over a dominant chord or a dominant flat 9 chord. So this first one, it sounds like this. All right, so what makes that phrase work? Every single note in there is actually just diatonic. But what makes it sound so melodic is that it's utilizing the full spectrum of all the available scale degrees, and it's doing it with a lot of interesting shapes and melodic contour, and it's always landing on nice chord tone. So what you'll see is that in beat 1 and 3, those are the places where you really want to be hitting the nice sounding chord tones. We've got to start. We've got the root, we've got the sharp 11, we've got the 5, we've got the 6, we've got the 6 again, the 6 again, and then the root, and the root. And then getting into all of that, a lot of times you're seeing very smooth voice leading, like what you see moving from beat 2 into beat 3 of the first bar, and from beat 2 into beat 3 of the second bar, and from beat 4 into beat 1 of the third to the fourth bar. You're gonna see some nice voice leading there, which makes it sound nice and connected and much more melodic than if you're just playing the notes randomly. Also, what I find really sounds good when you're playing diatonically is if you make sure you're using all the notes in the scale, so you're really flexible with the scale. That comes down to 2 things. One, taking phrases into all 12 keys is really going to help you master that type of thing. And then, of course, practicing your scale exercises in all 12 keys is going to make you really flexible and able to have the technique to do that sort of thing. So for the second phrase that we're going to check out here, we're going to look at a phrase that's using the diminished whole tone scale, which is also referred to as the altered scale. Now you can play phrases using the altered scale on a dominant chord, or anytime you see a dominant chord with an alt written after it. So what that means is if you see like C7 alt after it, that's going to be referring to the altered sound, which is defined by a sharp 9 and a flat 13. Now you'll see altered chords a lot, just like the flat 9 chord you'll see them a lot functioning in minor 2-5-1s. And that's a progression that we have a lot of phrases on in this PDF. So this PDF goes through using the diminished scale in the capacity of major 2-5-1s, minor 2-5-1s, 3-6-2-5s, rhythm changes, all sorts of real life practical situations where you can use these diminished phrases. So that's one of the shorter phrases in the PDF. There are a bunch of little two bar licks in there, just in case you prefer having little short phrases to integrate into your playing and just easier content to just get down really quickly and maybe take through the keys. And what's important to note is even though that phrase is short, it's only like a bar and a half long, we get all the notes in that altered scale into that phrase. I find phrases that use all the notes in a scale end up sounding really melodic because you're getting the full spectrum of that sound. Now it's important to know when I'm improvising, I'm not thinking to myself, let me figure out every note in the scale for me to improvise on it. So really what it is that I've practiced so much great content, like learning phrases like this and learning scale exercises that mechanically make it so I can play through this technique that's involved fluidly. When you practice all this stuff and you really internalize it, that's when you just start improvising through jazz like it's a language. So you don't need to feel like, oh my gosh, how am I going to constantly think about all the content that I need to play from these scales in order to improvise on a high level. It's not about that. You just practice the right stuff, you learn good phrases, you internalize it, you take it through some different keys, you memorize it. The more you do that, the more you're just going to improvise on a high level and just sound like you're speaking the language. All right, so for this third phrase, we're gonna check out another phrase that utilizes the half whole diminished scale, which again, you can use on a dominant chord or a dominant 7 flat 9 chord. However, this one's going to get into adding chromaticism. So what sounds really hip is when you go beyond just pushing the buttons of the scales with these diminished scales that you're learning, and when you start adding in chromaticism, so the non-diatonic notes from these scales, and using them in the phrases that you're playing. So that's going to be tricky. So here's an example of that with a phrase from the PDF. So in the same way that adding chromaticism to a major scale or a dominant scale or a minor Dorian scale can really make your playing sound a lot more interesting, the same goes for adding it to a diminished scale. You can really sound like you've mastered this sound when you start adding in chromaticism effectively. So how do you do it effectively? Well, really, chromaticism a lot of times is always going directionally into a more melodic note, like it's approaching a more melodic note. So what happens in that first bar, as you'll see, we'll play that D natural, and I'm speaking in concert here. That D natural is not diatonic in a C half whole diminished scale, but it ends up just acting as a passing note between two diatonic notes, that E flat right before it and that D flat that we land on in beat 4. And then throughout the rest of this phrase, you'll see a lot of A flats. Now sometimes the A flats are on the downbeat, and that's because they're acting as a two note enclosure around a G natural. So that happens in that second bar. That happens in the last bar, the fourth bar, right before the end. The G natural is the fifth, so it's still a very melodic chord tone, even when you're playing on a dominant 7 flat 9. So the other place that we use that A flat is in the third bar. You'll see it's acting as an approach note on the end of 2, going from beat 2 to beat 3, connecting the sixth degree, which is diatonic in the half whole diminished scale, and the fifth degree, which is also diatonic, and acts as a chord tone. All right, so now we're gonna use some diminished scales in context of some actual chord progressions here. So I mentioned that there are a lot of points in this PDF where we're actually using diminished scales on common chord progressions so we can get some really valuable context. And so what we're gonna do here is we're going to use some diminished scales on minor 2-5. So in this phrase, we're going to use the half whole diminished scale in bar 2, which is going to be where you've got your dominant 7 flat 9 chord in a minor 2-5. We're gonna use that half whole diminished scale. It's gonna sound really hip. Here it is. All right, so now we're back in diatonic territory. We're just playing notes from the scales here. And notice how hip it can still sound to just be using scale notes. We're going through three really hip sounds. We're using Locrian in that first bar on the half diminished 7. Your options for a half diminished 7 are technically going to be Locrian or Locrian natural 2, if you just want to raise that second or the ninth scale degree, depending on how you want to think about it. In the second bar, we're using that half whole diminished scale, as I mentioned earlier, on that dominant 7 flat 9. And in the last bar, we're using melodic minor. Now, what makes it sound so melodic is the fact that we're using smooth voice leading from bar to bar. So notice on beat 4, moving into beat 1 of the second bar. So this is beat 4 of the first bar, moving into beat 1 of the second bar. We're just diatonically wrapping around that sharp 11. So we play the diatonic note below it and the diatonic note above it, coming from that Locrian sound, landing on beat 1 of the second bar, landing on that half whole diminished scale sound. Now there's also smooth voice leading moving from beat 4 of the second bar into beat 1 of the third bar. Notice we're just going diatonically down, landing on that minor third in bar 3. Now the minor third is always one of the most melodic notes that you can land on when you're landing on a minor chord, so it makes it sound really nice there. So for the last phrase that we're going to check out on this video, we're going to look at a phrase that utilizes the whole half diminished scale. And a really great place to do that is on rhythm changes. Anytime you have a diminished chord, that's where you're going to technically want to use the whole half diminished scale. I find developing players a lot of times will sound pretty good and sound like they've got a decent handle over major, minor, and dominant chords. But then when it comes to playing diminished chords, and we see diminished chords all over the place in jazz standards or American songbook standards, when it comes to playing diminished chords, I really find the developing players fall flat and a lot of times just completely miss that sound. And to really nail that sound, you've really got to have a handle of your whole half diminished scale. So let's check that out now on the first few bars of a rhythm changes standard. So with rhythm changes, there are two options on how you play those first few bars. And we actually go through both of those options and phrases that you can play on them in the PDF. So essentially your two different options are going to be either playing a 1-6-2-5 in those first couple bars. So that's just going to be C major 7, A7, D minor 7, and G7. Or you could do this diminished thing where you play C major 7, D flat diminished 7, then D minor 7, and then E flat diminished 7. Then in bar 3, either way, you're going to a 3-6-2-5. So you'll notice with the diminished thing, we've got those diminished 7 chords go up a half step into minor 7 chords, which is a really nice sound. Now the PDF actually has phrases on all three of these different progression types. And the reason for that is with all of these three progressions, and all of these progressions are very standard stock progressions that you'll see in all sorts of different standards. With all three of these progressions, there's a lot of potential for playing diminished language. But what we're going to do now is we're just going to go through that progression with the C major 7, D flat diminished 7, D minor 7, and E flat diminished 7. But what we're going to do with this is we're going to spread it out. So we're going to do one bar of each. That allows us to really get these sounds deeper into our ears, so we're not just rushing through it, just playing two beats at a time. We're really going to have the opportunity to embrace each diminished seventh chord, and on each of those diminished seventh chords, you're going to see that we're going to use the whole half diminished scale. So let's check out this phrase number 5. So that example was just pretty diatonic all the way through, at least on the diminished 7 bars, just to keep it straightforward and make sure that you've got a handle of it. But we also go through some options in the PDF where we're also adding chromaticism to that sound, which ends up sounding really hip. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed those phrases. It gives you some stuff to work on just straight from the video here. If you want to go even more in depth and check out that PDF at jazzlessonvideos.com, you'll get all the phrases all written out in all 12 keys. In that instant PDF download, you'll also get links to videos with me playing through all of the phrases plus backing tracks. So it's going to be a really valuable resource to check out. All right, guys, so thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a comment in the comments section to let me know what you'd like me to hit with videos coming up. I'll have a little more time now that I'm off the road to do videos like this, so we'd love to hear from you. All right, see you guys soon.